USS Doris Miller Crest. In January of 2020, the United States Navy announced that the fourth Ford-class carrier would be named in honor of Doris Miller. The following is an explanation of the Crest design for the USS Doris Miller CVN-81. The foundation of the design is a 16-inch battleship gun barrel. Dorie was serving aboard the USS West Virginia when the attack on Pearl Harbor began. The motto on the crest is, "The Cornerstone of Freedom." This is very apropos, since freedom in actuality was likely quite scarce for an African-American born in the Deep South of a former Confederate state, a mere 54 years after the conclusion of the Civil War. Dorie was born on October 12, 1919, in Waco, Texas. He was the son of sharecroppers and the grandson of slaves. The carrier's motto is inspired by Frederick Douglass, Abraham Lincoln, and Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. President Lincoln wrote in his letter to Mrs. Bixby, a Massachusetts mother who had lost five sons in the Civil War, "I pray our Heavenly Father may assuage the anguish of your bereavement and leave you only with the cherished memory of the loved and lost and the solemn pride that must be yours to have laid so costly a sacrifice upon the altar of freedom." Dr. King often spoke of freedom in his speeches, as he did after the march from Selma to Montgomery in 1965. An excerpt from that speech is, "We are going to stand up amid anything they can muster up, letting the world know that we are determined to be free." Dr. King was also quoted as saying, "Lightning makes no sound until it strikes." Frederick Douglass, who was born into and escaped slavery to become one of the nation's greatest leaders in history, said, "Those who profess to favor freedom yet deprecate agitation are men who want crops without plowing up the ground. They want rain without thunder and lightning." Both Douglass and King speak of lightning. The future flight deck of the USS Miller will be abundantly inhabited with numerous Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II combat aircraft. There is even a lone F-35 Lightning incorporated in the crest and landing configuration above a swirling W in homage to Dorie's hometown of Waco, Texas. Coincidentally, USS Doris Miller, CVN-81, and the Cornerstone of Freedom are exactly the same number of characters and numbers. Surrounding the crest are exactly 102 quarterstones, which represent the 102 military ships present at Pearl Harbor during the attack December 7, 1941. Each of the 102 cornerstones are exactly equal, no cornerstone greater than any other. Equality is paramount to freedom. Lincoln said as much in the first sentence of the Gettysburg Address in 1863. 47 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. The interior of the gun barrel inside the crest is the flag of Texas turned on its side. World War II did just that to the Republic of Texas. Of the 419,400 American military personnel killed in World War II, over 22,000 were Texans. Dorie, of course, was among that sad statistic. The upper half of the crest includes the Atomic Texas Star. The Atomic Star is adorned with three high-energy atomic ovals with two visible electrons, which represent the two nuclear reactors that will power the Doris Miller. The color chosen for the symbolic ovals and electrons was Medal of Honor blue. Dorie, as we know, was not awarded the Medal of Honor, but came close, as the ovals and electrons are to the Texas Star. Foremost, the electrons and ovals convey advanced technology and energetic action, both human and mechanical. Also in the upper part of the crest, as mentioned, is a lone Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning. The loneness represents Dorie, the lone black man and lone enlisted man to have an aircraft carrier ever named in his honor. As mentioned, wake turbulence of an unseen departed, like Dorie, aircraft is symbolized by an Edwardian script W, representing Dorie's hometown of Waco. The portrait view of the actual carrier of the USS Doris Miller was so massive that its superstructure exceeds the boundaries of the inner circle, representing protection and defense capabilities that know no boundaries. This carrier image is set higher than any other carrier image in any crest in the Navy. Finally, the letters D and M in Morse code flank the left and right sides of the carrier in a salute to naval history cryptology and the code-breaking capability that helped bring an end to World War II in the Pacific via the tireless efforts of Joe Rochefort, his staff, and the code talkers of the Navajo Indian Nation. The lower right quarter has two components, an old-style boxing glove with leather straps. Boxing gloves of the time, like their football helmet counterparts, were merely leather mittens with modest extra padding. Velcro was invented in 1941, but it would be three decades before it was introduced into boxing. The orientation is raised vertically and high in victory. Like the glove, Dorie was left-handed, with a left hook that could, as some sailors said, sink a tugboat. Behind the glove is a silver V. This V has numerous meanings. Primarily, it represents, in Roman numerals, the number 5, the 5 battle stars awarded to the battleship USS West Virginia in World War II. It also denotes that Dorie was the West Virginia's boxing champion, the V standing for victory. The V also represents any number of powerful words, including valiant, vanquish, vaunted, vengeance, veritas, the Roman goddess of truth, veteran, and primarily, valor. In U.S. Naval and Marine Corps aviation, a V designates all fixed-wing aircraft squadrons. As for CVN that precedes the USS Miller's hull number, C represents an aircraft carrier. V, as mentioned above, indicates a ship that carries and launches primarily fixed-wing aircraft, and the N stands for nuclear-powered. The lower left quadrant has abundant symbology. The 6 stars represent the 6 ships that Dorie either served aboard or had named in his honor. A tilted star indicates that the ship fought in World War II. A level star indicates that the ship did not see combat. As for color, a blue star indicates the representative ship was lost at sea, either sunk by enemy fire or as a post-war gunnery torpedo target. A white star means the ship survived World War II. And a silver star indicates that the ship was built after World War II. The primary feature of the lower left quadrant is the gold lion. The Stoic lion, facing west towards Pearl Harbor and the Japanese Empire beyond, represents Dorie, as well as the attributes of strength, steadfastness, and courage. The lion also pays respective homage to Dorie Miller's African ancestry. At the base of the lion's neck is a crescent-shaped C, which was the U.S. Navy's designation, representative symbol for cook messmate during World War II. The lowest blue star represents the heavy cruiser USS Indianapolis. Dorie served aboard the Indy after the attack on Pearl Harbor. The Indianapolis was the last American ship lost in World War II, torpedoed and sunk by the Japanese submarine I-58 just after midnight on July 30, 1945. Of her crew of 1,195, 880 perished, the second deadliest sinking of a U.S. naval vessel in World War II behind the loss of the USS Arizona, which claimed 1,177 lives. In homage to the ship that helped end the war with Japan and the 880 crewmen lost, the Indianapolis is also remembered in the crest with a black silhouette at the 3 o'clock position, located in the gray circle. The second lowest ship, represented by a blue star, is the battleship Nevada. Dorie served aboard the Nevada in temporary duty assignment in July of 1941 before being transferred to the USS West Virginia. In July of 1948, after an extremely distinguished career that spanned over 3 decades in service in both world wars, the USS Nevada was sunk by an aerial torpedo after sustained gunnery practice failed to sink her. In the spring of 2020, her wreckage was discovered by Ocean Infinity, her remains at a depth of 15,400 feet, roughly 65 miles southwest of Oahu. The third blue star, located under the chin of the Gold Lion, represents the USS Liscome Bay. This was the Casablanca-class aircraft carrier escort ship that Dorie was serving aboard when, on November 12, 1943, the ship was sunk by Japanese submarine I-175. The Liscome Bay sank in just 23 minutes. Lieutenant John Dix, who witnessed the Liscome Bay's detonation from his ship, the destroyer USS Hoel, said, "It didn't look like a ship at all. We thought it was an ammunition ship. She just went up, whoom, an orange ball of flame." Dorie was among the 644 crew who perished in the sinking, the 7th deadliest sinking of a naval ship in World War II. The Liscome Bay's representative blue star is the closest to the Gold Lion's heart and the highest of the 3 blue stars. The Liscome Bay's remains rest on the ocean floor at a depth of 12,500 feet. A black silhouette of the USS Liscome Bay is set in the gray circle at the 9 o'clock position. Note that the Gold Lion gazes upon the silhouette of the USS Liscome Bay. Dorie, looking upon the ship upon which he and 643 of his shipmates perished, never to forget. The lower of the 2 white stars represents the battleship USS West Virginia, the ship upon which Dorie enshrined himself with his heroic actions on December 7, 1941. The WV survived World War II, struck in 1959. The highest of the 2 white stars represents the first ship Dorie was assigned to, the ammunition ship USS Pyro. The Pyro was also anchored at Pearl Harbor during the attack, suffering minor damage while being credited with damaging a Nakajima B-5N2 Kate torpedo bomber. As the White Star indicates, the Pyro survived the war, and was decommissioned in June of 1946 before being scrapped. The sixth and final star represented on the lower left quadrant represents the Knox-class destroyer USS Miller, FF-1091, the first ship named after Doris Miller. The Miller was commissioned 30 years after Dorie was killed, June 30th, 1973, and decommissioned on October 15th, 1991, just 3 days after what would have been Dorie's 72nd birthday. The position of the USS Miller's representative Silver Star is intentionally behind the Lion's field of vision, unaware of things to come. The Miller did not see combat action during her numerous Atlantic deployments, which is the reason why the star is level, unlike the five other stars, each representing ships that fought during World War II. Alternate versions of the crest created include the cursive Dorie version and night operations versions of both the primary crest and the cursive Dorie crest. If you approve of these crests and feel they appropriately honor Dorie Miller and all those who served in World War II, please press like and post your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you for taking time to watch this video.